of the gospel. And the gospel is a declaration of the Trinity in action. The gospel is a basis for the Trinity in action. And how do we take that belief in the Trinity and go out and act? Our catechism says the mystery of the Holy Trinity is the central mystery of the Christian faith and of the Christian life. By the grace of baptism, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we are called to share in the life of the Blessed Trinity here on earth and after in eternal light. Then there's the trouble of math with the Trinity. We know that 1 plus 1 plus 1 equals 3. Both the Trinity, 3 equals 1. So there's three distinct parts of the Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And then each one of them is all three. One of our parishioners who used to teach elementary school said that she used the model of a parent for telling her kids about what the Trinity was about. She said, you know, your mom and dad are your mom and dad, but at any point, they can also be a nurse, a cook, a driver, a reconciler. And so when they're in that role, they're not just the cook, they're also mom. About your families as well. There's many people in your family. You have siblings, you have aunts, uncles, parents. So each of you are separate in that family. And yet, when you unify, you're always part of that one family. My sister lives in the state of Virginia, so she's still part of the Whitehurst family, even though she's not here, and she's still vegan. She's also the golden child, but we won't get into that today. St. Augustine has said that when you see the Trinity, you see the Trinity if you see love. You see the Trinity if you see love. And I think as we reflect on the Trinity, hopefully going forward from today, just to take into account a little bit more about those connections that you see between each other, but also our connection to the natural world, our connection to what's going on in the news. That's all part of the Trinity, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. That relationality is so important because we were never meant to live alone. For many of us, that's why we seek out places like church. There's community here. I've been reminded of recent days listening to the news of those folks, those prisoners who are in solitary confinement, some of them for years at a time, which is just so detrimental to their spirits and their souls. So we get that sense of just how important community and humanity is. And that's why when we come to this space, my struggles are not just my struggles, but they're all of our struggles if we really are Christians and live in community. That's why we want you to give us a call when you might be in the hospital or when there's something going on in your house where you might need a little bit of extra support. Because that's what we're here for. We want to be able to reach out and help you during those times. And again, that shares that the Trinity is relational. Would view the Trinity probably as me, myself, and I. And that's why as people of faith, we have a much different view of Trinity. God is the creative force. You'll hear the lovely reading from Proverbs this morning about how God delights and plays in that creative energy. Jesus is more of that reconciler or healer, healing those broken places. And then the Holy Spirit is there that reminds us of how we're grounded and how do we seek out truth in our lives. And the Trinity can be a model for all of our relationships. How can we be creative in building up each other and the family of God? How can we be like the Son reconciling our lives one to another? And how can we be like the Holy Spirit speaking truth to power and recognizing every reaching out for companionship, every urge for a hug or an embrace, every act of love gives indirect testimony to the presence in and belief of the Trinity. During our liturgy today, at the Gifts, we sing a song with a wonderful refrain that goes like this: thank you, God, for giving us your Son and leading your Spirit till the work on earth is done. May every time we pray in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, call us to creative communion, compassionate feeling, or honest interaction, and above all, deeper love.
The weekend after Pentecost is always Trinity Weekend, Trinity Sunday. And as Molly was explaining to us before Mass began, that the Trinity, that's a tough concept. People still struggle with that. It's that whole idea of recognizing what it means. And as she explained, it really is about relationship. The relationship of the three members of the Trinity, Father, to the Son, and the Holy Spirit. But also the relationship that we have to the Godhead, or the three in one, but also to each other. Now she said a quote there, I'll catch it from St. Augustine. He's one of the big heavy hitters of our church, one of the big thinkers. He says, you will see the Trinity if you see love. I like that. Or another way of thinking, you will recognize Trinity when you recognize love. Or even the opposite. If there is no love, then you're not going to see the Trinity. For all of us, it's easy to love those who are lovable. You know, kittens, babies, we got that, okay. It's tougher when there's people we don't get along with. I hate them, but you know, we just butt heads, whether it's a family member, a neighbor, a coworker, a classmate. But indeed, if the Trinity makes sense, it's because we are invited into a relationship of love. Just as God will love us even in our bad points, even when we make mistakes, so we are invited to do the same. So I want you to do is I want you to think of somebody right now who you're having a tough time with loving. I mean, someone you actually know. You can close your eyes. You have somebody to close your eyes. And I want you to think of what you can start doing differently toward them. Maybe it's not gossip so much. Maybe not always look for bad points. Maybe it's start affirming them. Maybe it's be more thankful for what they have. Not how they can change, how you can change. We as followers of Jesus are invited into a relationship. A relationship of love. Begins with how we actively try to be better, to be different. If that relationship, the Trinity, is to make sense, it's because it makes sense in our actions. The way that we look, that we reach out, we become instruments. Well, on a day like this, we are celebrating family. Joshua, invite them to bring the little one forward along with the godparents. As we celebrate this gift of love in their lives, quiet. One of the godparents adds a little bit of holy water from our font in front of this warm water. Almighty and ever-living God, you sent Jesus in the world to cast out the spirit of evil, to rescue us from the kingdom of darkness, to bring us all into the splendor of the kingdom of light. We pray for us. Set him free from all harm. Make him a temple of your glory, and send your Holy Spirit to dwell with him. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please stand. Let us reaffirm our faith commitments and renew our vows of baptism along with this family as we all say I do. Do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children?
I do.
Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin?
I do.
Do you reject Satan, the father of sin and prince of darkness?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Creator Almighty, maker of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus? died, was buried, rose from the dead, and now sits at God's right hand.
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the church. Joshua and Rachel, it's your wish to have your son baptized into this faith.
Yes.
Please be seated. Bring him forward. God grants you stand tonight. Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, so you are to be anointed.